Well, there's a new twist to the missionaries of a charity child trafficking scandal. Doctor who blew the lid of the child trafficking scandal at the missionaries of charity in Jharkhand spoke exclusively to India Today. Claims that he flagged the issue way back in 2014, but the authorities didn't do anything. Take a look at this report.
Mother Teresa established Missionaries of Charity is in the dock. India Today tracked down the whistleblower who was the first one to flag off the suspected baby selling racket at the charity's Ranchi branch. OP Singh, the former chairman of Child Welfare Committee Ranchi, raised the alarm in 2014 about child trafficking.
पहले भी ऑफिस बेरर हुआ करते थे लेकिन वो कभी जांच कभी यहां देखने भी नहीं आते थे.
He claims the sisters did not cooperate with the probe and eventually he was shunted out.
हमारे पर चार्जेस लगाया गया कि आप किस प्रावधान के तहत उस पर वहां गए थे और यही कह के आप उन्होंने हम पर हमको सस्पेंड कर दिया.
What Singh claimed 4 years ago is now out in the open. Two nuns and a woman employee of Missionaries of Charity's Ranchi branch are in police custody for alleged role in child trafficking. What they revealed is shocking. They allegedly sold babies for a price, in some instances for 1 lakh rupees. Based on the confession, the police are on a lookout for 3 babies and others involved in the racket.
वो इन्वेस्टिगेशन चल रहा है, अगर कुछ और बात आती है तो उसमें फर्दर कार्रवाई करते हुए विधि सम्मत कार्रवाई की जाएगी.
पुलिस हैव कास्ट देयर नेट वाइड. दे रेस्क्यूड अनदर चाइल्ड ऑन मंडे. दिस इन्फेंट वाज अलेजेडली सोल्ड फॉर 50,000 रुपीस फ्रॉम द मिशनरीज ऑफ चैरिटी शेल्टर लास्ट ईयर. द कपल हु बॉट द चाइल्ड एस्केप्ड इवन एज द पुलिस कंडक्टेड रेड्स.
सिस्टर कौंसिलिया से पूछताछ की गई तो उनके द्वारा ये सारी बातों को एक्सेप्ट किया गया. इसके अतिरिक्त 3 और ऐसे इन्होंने बच्चों को बेचा है.
द पुलिस क्लेम एन अंडरएज मदर गिव बर्थ टू दिस चाइल्ड एट निर्मल हृदय लास्ट दिसंबर. द डील टू सेल द चाइल्ड वाज अलेजेडली स्ट्रक एट द रांची डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल. द झारखंड चाइल्ड राइट्स बॉडी हैज नाउ डिमांडेड अ सर्च एट ऑल सेंटर्स ऑफ मिशनरीज ऑफ चैरिटी.
और भी संस्थाएं हैं जो सरकारी द्वारा या गैर सरकारी संस्थाओं के द्वारा जो रन किए जा रहे हैं उनको उनके लिए भी जांच का आदेश आयोग ने दिया है.
इन्वेस्टिगेशंस हैव रिवील्ड दैट 26 चिल्ड्रन वर बोर्न इन द मिशनरीज ऑफ चैरिटी इंस्टीट्यूशन इन 2017. व्हाइल 2 चिल्ड्रन वर बोर्न डेड, देयर इज नो ट्रेस ऑफ द रिमेनिंग 24. The probe has also revealed that there were 450 pregnant women in Nirmal Hriday between 2015 and 18, but only 170 delivery reports are available. The Child Welfare Committee of the Jharkhand government is now on the lookout for unmarried mothers who deliver children at Nirmal Hriday. The state government has assured a thorough probe.
Kanuni karwai karni chahiye. ये प्रशासन की जिम्मेदारी है, वो जिम्मेदारी को निर्वाह कर रहे हैं.
द मिशनरीज ऑफ चैरिटी हैज एक्सप्रेस्ड शॉक एट द टर्न ऑफ इवेंट्स.
इट्स एब्सोल्युटली शॉकिंग, कंप्लीटली शॉकिंग फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस एट मिशनरीज ऑफ चैरिटी टू बिलीव दैट दिस हैज हैपेंड.
एज मदर टेरेसा हैज शेयर्ड ट्रेमेंडस गुडविल अमंगस्ट द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया, बीइंग वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर नोबेल लॉरिएट्स. With this incident now coming to light, it's not just the missionaries of charity, but even her own goodwill and credibility that now faces a huge question mark in this country. With camera person Chitra Bhanu Pathak, Indrajit for India Today.
Now, this is our top focus on the burning question. We at India Today are asking, missionaries of charity selling newborn babies, is it an epidemic problem as far as the organization is concerned or an aberration? In fact, Mother Teresa's charity involved in child trafficking racket since 2014 and Jharkhand government in slumber. Whistleblowers, doctors' warning were ignored and nexus between Jharkhand government and the charity trust. Is it now apparent and very clear? Joining me on the broadcast is my colleague Indrajit Kundu. We are also being joined by John Dayal, Secretary General of All India Christian Council. Raghav Awasthi, RSS ideologue, is also with us on the broadcast. Sanil Ilok Kamandu is the president of the Indian Rationalist Association. He's joining us as well. Gopal Agarwal of the BJP is also on the broadcast. I want to start, in fact, with you, Indrajit. You have been in Ranchi. What are the administration saying about the fact that from 2014, this doctor was, in fact, speaking about this entire racket and no action was taken?
Well, you know, we spoke to the doctor. You know, he was the chairperson of the Child Welfare Committee here in Ranchi. So he was at the helm of affairs as far as investigating such, you know, tip-offs were concerned. And he claims that he got a tip-off in 2014, flagged off the matter, went himself to Nirmal Hirdey to probe this matter, but he was stonewalled. And subsequently, he was removed from his position. And now he claims that he has been vindicated with his case surfacing and two children being recovered by the CWC here in Ranchi, the same organization for which he was conducting the probe. The police, of course, has begun probe. There are four children whom the two people who have been arrested, a nun and an employee of the Missionaries of Charity, they have confessed to selling four children over the past 1 year. Two of those children have already been recovered. The police is trying to trace the other remaining two at this point. And they're telling us that there are several discrepancies as far as these, you know, births that have been given under the aegis of Missionaries of Charity by several women who take shelter in their shelter home. So they are probing all these documents at this point in time. And there are several agencies which is doing it at the same time. The CWC, the Jharkhand State Commission for Protection of Child Rights, along with the Jharkhand Police.
Stay on with me, Indrajit. I'm going to come back to you as well for more details on this story. Let me get in John Dayal. John Dayal, the question, of course, would be whether this is an endemic, an epidemic problem as far as the other agencies are also concerned, other shelters of Missionaries of Charity is also concerned, or should we only see it as an aberration which took place in Jharkhand and that is how it should be looked at?
Three small points this morning. The official spokesman of the Missionaries of Charity has said the mission is shocked. And you cannot exceed that statement. We are all shocked that this is happening. The Missionaries of Charity are not just in Ranchi. They're a global mission. They have homes like this across the world, across India. So I would say, prima facie, let there be an inquiry globally so that they're exonerated and the fair name of Mother Teresa is exonerated and her mission and its value and its purpose in society is vindicated. In India, it lies with the police to investigate it to the fullest. There is no defense of any criminality. What I have come here to talk about is, even on this panel, it is the BJP panel, there are so many of them. What is the politicization of this and the implications of say the since yesterday, the way the RSS is there, the way you are attacking not the criminality, you're attacking the whole of the Christian community and its social input. And that I would like to challenge. The criminality, no defense, no excuse.
Okay.
Investigate it, okay. Punish it to the fullest.
Right. Gopal Agarwal, John Dayal is making a charge that the BJP is trying to politicize this entire issue on the lines of religion. There has been criminality angle which has been unearthed by the police. There are two nuns and one person who has already been arrested. The police is investigating. Why jump the gun? Why associate it with the religion?
With all due respect to Mother Teresa, I would like to state that how do you say when Mr. John Dayal says that who is politicizing? When there is a criminality involved in any of this activity, they talk of criminality and not religion. But when there is cow vigilantism, they talk of BJP and RSS being involved. Who politicizes this issue, you tell us? What is politicization? When, if you talk on criminality, then talk on criminality on every issue. If any person who has done criminal activity on any concern, then their whole debate should be only restricted to criminality. If you become selective, and when you become selective, it is correct. When other become talk of this, then you talk of politicizing the issue. Is not the difference which you are talking about, Mr. Dayal. The issue is there is a criminality involved, and it is not an isolated case.
So are you,
criminality are there in isolated cases?
Let him complete. I'm going to give you time. I'm going to give you time. I'm not going to have ruckus on the debate. John Dayal, I request you very politely.
Yes.
Let him complete and then please speak. This is not the debate. This is not the channel where we speak over each other. Let him complete his point. Go ahead, Gopal Agarwal, quickly.
Yes. The issue is when you your report says that 450 pregnant women were there and delivery is only 117, what does it mean? It's a deep-rooted systematic malice or a criminality involved in isolation cases. The issue is very deep-rooted. There are
And that is exactly the investigation would be looking into, Gopal Agarwal. And that is exactly what the investigation would be looking into it. But Is it fair? And I want to bring in Raghav Awasthi on this before I get John Dayal to respond to what they are saying. Raghav Awasthi, is this fair to somehow try and blame the entire missionaries of charity or a religion when it comes to incident like this? There will be aberrations from every religion. Criminals are criminals. It doesn't matter which religion do they belong to.
Ankit, when this Kathua rape case happened, and now it seems that the facts are different from what were being portrayed earlier, there were sections of the media that lapped up the propaganda of people like John Dayal, who tried to paint adherents of an entire religion, that is Hinduism, as rapists. So it's really unfortunate that John Dayal, people like John Dayal are crying foul now. Coming back to the point, nobody is saying that it's all Christians in India who are part of this some sort of, you know, this baby selling conspiracy. Having said that, when there is clear evidence that has been unearthed, then questions will be asked of the missionaries of charity. This will in no way serve to diminish Mother Teresa's legacy. But as a matter of fact, those who are beneficiaries and legatees of Mother Teresa's good name and reputation, they should answer the tough questions now. And people like John Dayal should not obfuscate. They should allow those tough questions to be asked.
John Dayal, is that what the entire agenda is? So somehow try and push it into BJP and the RSS both are saying if it happens at in the case of Kathua, then you blame the entire religion. When it comes to the missionaries of charities, you are trying to stonewall it. Let there be an extensive investigation from the top to the bottom of the missionaries of charity to unearth whether there is a larger conspiracy in this or not.
You know, most Hindus would
reject the
BJP.
It's really unfortunate that the people like
Raghav,
the Hindu religion.
Raghav, you've made your point. Let John Dayal respond.
No, allow me. Since this is not a channel where we speak over each other, allow me my 30 seconds.
Precisely, sir. Please go ahead.
Most Hindus reject the RSS BJP claim that they represent the Hindu religion. RSS and BJP represent a virulent politics. I don't want to say anything more. I have already said, let the criminality be investigated by the highest authorities in the country, because the ashrams are all over the country. So let us say we investigate every ashram. Now let me come to the facts of this case. 250 pregnancies are not reported. Perhaps the pregnant women came here and went back and delivered elsewhere. Let the facts of the case be investigated, unless you're saying that 250 women were killed or something of the sort.
Sir, no, nobody is saying that. But please also, when you are asking for an investigation, don't try and presuppose these things, whether the women were there or not. Let the investigation take place. 280 women, what happened to them? What happened to the children? This is exactly what the investigations are going to unearth. I also want to bring in Sanal very quickly. Sanal, is there a problem? Is it more endemic of the fact of the kind of training that is given to the people? Because it's not only the name of missionaries of charities, but also a larger problem of child trafficking in the country. And if nuns are involved, if two of the nuns have been arrested, if there is a middleman which has been arrested, does it mean that there needs to be larger sensitization, more robust training, be it missionaries of charity or any other organization handling children?
I think one of the major things that we have to, when we can think about missionaries of charity, the fundamental nature of the functioning of Missionaries of Charity has some problem per se. For example, the way children are handled in orphanages, there have been cases of mistreatment of children. For example, for a small stealing, metallic things boiled and put on their body. There was a case recently, some years back in Calcutta. So I still remember the fundamental approach, which has been very clearly said when Sister Nirmala, after Mother Teresa, took over the charge in a press conference. When I was a journalist at Delhi, I was also attending there. She was asked, you are giving some soup to the poor people, but what about finding a political solution for ending poverty? She said the answer was very clear to making their approach. They said, if poor people are not there, we will be out of business. Poverty, orphan children are business for missionaries of charity. This is a fundamental approach of them. And I would propose that the whole action of missionaries of charity need to be investigated right from the time of Mother Teresa, because during Mother Teresa's time, this was one charity organization which did not file income tax returns ever. And her position was, I am answerable only to Jesus. So she, from the Mother Teresa onwards, there has been an approach which was not respecting the legal system.
Okay.
The responsibilities.
Okay, let's get John Dayal to respond on that. John Dayal, is this also, and I'm just reiterating that question, a systemic problem of how the missionaries of charities function all across? The problem not only in training, but in the way they take forward their work. As Sunil is pointing out, many instances in which they possibly believe that they can get away with the law of the land.
No, Sunil is a rationalist and a very old friend of mine, as his father also was. They are against superstition. They are against... No, I'm not exonerating. I'm coming to that. I'm admitting to what you're saying. The fact is, Sunil's argument is the whole thrall that religion and faith have on society, irrespective of the religion. Now coming to the specifics of Mother Teresa Ashram, there are two aspects of it. There's the internal aspect. Does Mother Teresa believe in Jesus? Who's to stop her from believing in Jesus? But does the ashram not pay its, FCRA documents? Does it not submit its accounts? That's a technical problem in which it interfaces with the government of India, and it is for the government to prosecute them if they're violating the law. I would be the last person to prevent the government of India legitimately prosecuting any religion which violates the law.
Okay. I want to get Gopal Agarwal, back into the debate. And Gopal Agarwal, I in fact want specific answers. We have spoken about missionaries of charities, but what about the role and accountability of the Jharkhand government? I can go back to instances, and the whistleblower in this case, as he met my colleague Indrajit Kundu as well and told him that in 2014, way back in 2014, he in fact blew the lid off this, but nobody took any action. This is not the first time that a charity shelter in Ranchi has come on the allegations of alleged child trafficking. It was the chairperson Om Prakash Singh of the child welfare panel, which had written to the government saying that his voice is being suppressed. Is it now also a time to look into who are the people in the BJP government in Jharkhand who are hand in gloves? The government of Jharkhand can also just not wash its hands of what is happening in the Ranchi shelters.
Definitely. Wherever there is a criminality involved, the government has to take action. And if it has not taken action, the accountability stands with the government. They are to be accountable. But I would like to mention one more thing, Ankit. The issue is when there is a camouflage of this charity and etc., and when there is so many powerful people involved in globally, internationally.
No, what do you mean by camouflage of charity? Are you saying that they are not a charitable organization? They are not doing anything apart from illegal criminality? Is that what assertion is? Mr. Agarwal?
Yeah, Ankit, yes, I tell you. Yes, let me tell what I want to mean is that there are various allegations on missionaries of charities with regard to conversion, etc. And people like senior people like Mr. John Dayal, when they talk of then start talking of first prove the criminality investigation, these issues, they definitely have an effect.
No, but who stops you from investigating that? You are the government in power in Jharkhand and across the country as well. Who stops you? Don't use it to score political brownie points. If Missionary of Charity is doing anything wrong, put all of them behind bars. Who stops you from doing that?
No.
He's making an ass of himself. He's not scoring any points at all. He's exposing himself.
Hold on, John. Let him complete. You have to answer the specific question, Mr. Agarwal. Why don't you shut down Missionaries of Charities if they are involved in illegal activities? You can't come on national television and say they are involved in illegal activities and they should be investigated. Who will investigate it? The government at the center and the government in Jharkhand.
Let me tell you. The issue is how you investigate. If you start investigation, there is a political this government is doing this. So first, how do you prove criminality? You only prove criminality with evidence, not by coming on television and making baseless allegations.
That is how the system and the constitution in this country works. Raghav, yes. I want to come to you. But is it fair? How do you investigate? RSS might have a view of how Mother Teresa or conversions or how the entire missionary system works. But will it be fair if the government believes so deeply or the BJP believes so deeply that this is just a camouflage of charity that the Missionaries of Charity is involved in? Shouldn't it put everybody behind bars? You can't have this argument that they are doing something wrong and we won't do it because there is political pressure.
Definitely.
No, but
all of these people who belong to the Missionaries of Charity and who are found to be guilty as far as this scandal is concerned should definitely be put behind bars. There are many provisions under law that are available, and now the onus is upon the government of Jharkhand and the government of India to ensure that those who are guilty are brought to book as expeditiously as possible. There can be no two ways about that.
Sanal, is it also the time where, this could be taken as a point in example? Whosoever is involved, apart from punishing them, the government should rethink about how the adoption process in this country does take place.
I think that's a very fair proposal that you have made. The whole adoption process has to be investigated properly, and there should be a kind of very clear and transparent system working on that. Because in most of the cases, what happens is, at one stage you promote, you claim that, people should have the right to produce children and there should be no family planning, there is no birth control, and you promote children being produced at one side. And on the other side, when there is an allegation, right or wrong, coming that this is misused, to promote orphanages, this is misused for selling children. It has to be investigated, the whole structure. Adoption is an important issue, very sensitive issue,
yes,
and it needs to be investigated thoroughly. And one more point, please. No organization, whether it's religious or otherwise, should not be treated as a holy cow.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I completely agree with you there. John Dayal, you want to make a point, but I'm completely out of time. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining me on this broadcast. Important thing. Two things that people need to watch out for. As Sanal was saying, no religious organization, no matter which religion it belongs to, can be considered as a holy cow. There is a law of the land that has to be adhered to. And if you are against that, if you are found against the law, you have to pay the consequences. And number two, the accountability as far as the government is concerned. These things can't be used for political brownie points. It can't be about religion. It is about evidence, investigation, and bringing to book those responsible. Thank you so much for joining me on this burning question debate.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share, and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.